Hi dear students, welcome to Geeta's classes. We have started double integrals in M2. Now we will see change of order of integration. Very important topic. One definite question you can expect for even for university exam. Okay. So before that, you should remember these things. Dx dy means horizontal strip. You have to always consider dx dy means horizontal strip. Find the limits of x. Then move the strip from bottom to top and find the limits of y. Similarly, if it is dy dx, then vertical strip, you have to consider the vertical strip. From both the ends, find the limits of y and move the strip from left to right in the given region to cover the region and find the limits of x. Okay, this you have to remember. You cannot forget this. You have to by heart these things, right? So now let us see. Change of order of integration. Directly I'll explain in the problem. Change the order of integration and evaluate the integral, and hence evaluate integral 0 to 1, integral 4y to 4 e power x squared. Can you tell me whether it is dx dy or dy dx? Here you have y, therefore you can have dx only first. Okay, so dy, dx dy. Even if they sometimes to confuse you, they will give dy dx, then you should be able to correct it. Okay, so if you have variables in the inner limit, please check the given order is correct or not, right? That is the first thing. And why do we need to change the order of integration directly? Why don't we integrate directly? Why should we change the order of integration? That is important point. Nothing, very simple. If the given integration is difficult, okay, it will be, sometimes it will be difficult to integrate. See, e power x squared, you have to make the substitution and all, right? So instead of that, again, we don't have x here. It will be very tedious process to integrate with respect to x here, because if you have e power x squared. So if it is with respect to y, then it will be easy. Only for our convenience, to make the integration simple. Okay. So here, given the order is, so first step is find the given order. Write the given order is dx dy. Okay. And before that, before changing the order, first you have to draw the region. So given order is dx dy means what? These 4y and 4 are the limits of x, right? So x is equal to 4y and x is equal to 4. Then y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. These two limits are for x. These two limits are for y. Okay. So x, these are the four curves. The region bounded by these four curves. Let us draw this region first. So x is equal to 4. X, you know the simple lines, let us draw first. So y is equal to 0 is the x axis, right? This is x axis. This is y axis. This is the origin. So this is the line y is equal to 0. This is the line x is equal to 0. And y is equal to 0 is this line, means somewhere here it will be y is equal to parallel to x axis. Okay, parallel to y is equal to 0 will be y is equal to 1, and x is equal to 4, x is equal to 0 is this line, so x is equal to 4 is this line, x is equal to 4. Okay, so we have y is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, x is equal to 4, and x is equal to 4y. See, all the other lines we have drawn very easily, but how to draw this line x is equal to 4y? Whenever you don't know how to draw these lines, please substitute some points. Okay. So let us substitute x is equal to 0. Then what will be y is equal to? What will be the value of y? Is equal to 0. Or y is equal to 0 also, you can substitute, you will get x is equal to 0. So we got 1.0, 0. Let us substitute y is equal to 1. Okay. Then what will be the x value? X is equal to 4 into 1. So if I substitute y is equal to 1, x will become 4 into 1, which is 4. So 4 comma 1. X comma y always, remember that. Okay. So I got 2 points, 4 comma 1 and 0 comma 0. 0 comma 0 is this point. 4 in this and y in this. This is the point 4 comma 1, right? Somewhere here. Okay. So this is the point 4 comma 1. This is the line y is equal to 1. Okay. Measurements may not be exact. Okay. So this is 0 comma 0. This is the origin 0 comma 0. So just join these two points. You will be getting. So this is the line y is equal to x is equal to 4y. So, y is equal to 0, y is equal to 1 and x equal to 4 and y is equal to 0. Sorry, x is equal to 4. So, I am telling that this is the region. Whenever you draw the region, you check whether we have drawn the region correctly or not. Okay. And sometimes you may think that why we are not shading this region. I will show you. See, what are the lines? X is equal to 4y, x is equal to 4, y is equal to 0, y is equal to 1. The given order is dx, dy. Okay. So, if I draw this, this is y is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, x equal to 4. X is equal to 4 and this is x equal to 0, right? If I shade this region, what will happen? We are thinking that it is y is equal to 0. Why can't it be this point, right? Sometimes this is 4 comma 1. This is 4 comma 1, right? Now, if I shade this region, what will happen? Whenever you shade the region, immediately you check whether the given order is correct or not. This is the given order. So, if I consider dx, dy, then you have to find out the, you have to consider the horizontal strip, right? Dx, this is the given region. I have not touched anything. I am checking whether it is correct or not. So, dx, dy means from both the ends, find the values of x, right? So, this is the line x is equal to 4y, right? So, left hand side is moving along the line x is equal to 0, 2. Right hand side is moving along the line x is equal to 4y. Okay. Then move the strip from left bottom to top. Bottom it can come up to the point origin. That is, so y is equal to 0 to y is equal to, up to this point it will go. So y is equal to, at this point y is equal to 1. Is it correct? Is this the region limits given? No. This is wrong. Therefore, whenever after shading this, this is wrong. Right? Therefore, what you have to do is here this is the shaded portion, right? So if you consider, now we check, I'm telling that this is the region. You need not believe just like that. Okay, you check. Now x is equal to, from both the, now given order is dx dy, right? So x varies from, left hand side is moving along the line x is equal to 4y, right? And right hand side is moving along the line x is equal to 4. Yes, correct. This is the given limits, right? So 4y to 4. Yes, correct. Then y varies from, y can come up to the point y is equal to 0. So y is equal to 0 to, it can go up to the point 4 comma 1 in which y is equal to 1. Yes. So this is the shaded portion. I hope you understood why the other portion is not shaded. If you shade like this, this is not correct because this is not the given limits. Okay. Given limits is, limits are different. X is equal to 4y and x is equal to 4, not 0 to 4y. If you draw this region, then this will be the limits, which is not correct. Okay. Therefore, after shading, please check whether we have shaded correctly or not. Okay. So now what you have to do is change the order now. Change the order now. What will be the changed order? Dy dx, right? Dy dx. Or I'll write here. Dy dx. Dy dx means what? Vertical strip. You have to consider the vertical strip, right? In this vertical strip, this is the vertical strip. From both the ends, find the values of y. So y varies from 0 to. This is the upper part is, this side is moving along the line x is equal to 4y, in which y value is x by 4, right? And move the strip from left to right. Left, it can come up to the point 0, 0, at which x is equal to 0. To right hand side, it can go up to the point 4, 1. 4, 1. Therefore, x is at this point, x is equal to 4. So these are the new limits. Okay. So let us check. So y varies from now, changed order is dy dx. Changed order is dy dx, in which y varies from 0 to y is equal to x by 4, and x varies from 0 to x is equal to 4. Okay. So therefore the given integral becomes, therefore the given integral is, or required integral is, integral, double integral, e power, what is the function? E power x squared, right? E power x squared into changed order, you have to write now dy dx. What are the limits? 0 to x by 4. Y limits are 0 to x by 4 and x limits are 0 to 4. Okay. So this is equal to, now you have to evaluate, that's all. So integral 0 to 4, integral 0 to, now yeah, I'm going to integrate this with respect to y. So e power x squared is to be treated as a constant. So e power x squared, you keep it as it is. Then y from 0 to x by 4 into dx, right? So integral 0 to 4 e power x squared into x by 4 minus 0 into dx. That is equal to 1 by 4 into integral. I'm going to integrate this now. So e power x squared, integral 0 to 4 e power x into e power x squared into x into dx. This is the integral. Now you have to make the substitution. So the required integral is equal to integral 1 by 4 into integral 0 to 4 e power x squared into x into dx. I'll multiply and divide it by 2. Okay. Let's see that. So put x squared. Again you have to substitute. X squared is equal to t. So 2x dx is equal to dt. When x is, whenever you substitute, you have to find out the remaining three things. One is dx, lower limit and upper limit. Okay. So when x is equal to 0, t will also be equal to 0. When x is equal to 4, t will be 16, right? T is 16. Therefore, now you want 2x dx. We have only 1x. So, multiply and divide it by 2. Okay. So, this will become 1 by 8 into integral 0 to 16. When x is equal to 0, t lower limit is the same, 0. But upper limit is changing to 16 into e power x squared is what? T. And 2x dx is dt, right? So this is equal to 1 by 8 into e power t from 0 to 16. Integral of e power t is e power t only. So 1 by 8 into e power 16 minus e power 0. That is equal to 1 by 8 into e power 16 minus 1. This is the answer. Okay. So otherwise, now if you have 2x dx, you have x, no? So the substitution will be easier, okay? Otherwise, it is not that easy to integrate e power x squared. It will be very difficult, okay? Only thing is to make it easier, to make the integration easier. That is why we are changing the order, okay? So even in the exam, if it is mentioned that change the order of integration, you have to change. Otherwise, you can proceed as it is. Okay. So next question. One more question we'll see. Change the order of integration. Change the order of integration in integral 0 to 1, integral x squared to 2 minus x into xy dx dy, and hence evaluate it. This is the question given. Whenever you have variables in the limits, please check whether the given order is correct or not. Here, given order is what? Is it correct? Dx, dy, is it correct? No. Because you have x here, you can have y only. So, given order is not correct. So, given order is dy, dx. Okay. You have to change this as dy, dx. It is not correct. So, it should be dy, dx. Right? So, rewrite it as dy, dx. Therefore, the given order is dy dx. Immediately after writing the order, write the limits. So, what are the curves? Y is equal to x squared. Y is equal to 2 minus x. And x varies from 0 to 1. So, these are the four curves. Okay. Now, x equal to 0, x is equal to 1, y is equal to x squared, y is equal to 2 minus x. Okay. So, first let us draw the curves. Y is equal to x squared. Y is equal to 2 minus x will become x plus y is equal to 2. This is a straight line. X plus y is equal to 2 and x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. These are the curves. Okay. So, y is equal to x squared is a parabola. Always remember, if both the variables are having power 1, it is a straight line. Okay. If one variable is having power 2, then it is a parabola. You should know all these basic curves. Okay. So, y is equal to x squared is a parabola which is symmetric about the y axis. Right. This is the line. Y is equal to, this is a curve. Y is equal to x squared. This is the parabola. Okay. Now, this is the line x-axis origin, this is y-axis, and this is the line y is equal to 0, this is the line x equal to 0, right? Now, one more line is there, x plus y is equal to 2. How to draw this? You know that it is a straight line. Therefore, so, let us substitute x equal to 0 for the line x plus y is equal to 2. When you substitute x is equal to 0, y will become 2. So, 0 comma 2 is 1 point, right? When you substitute y is equal to 0, you will get x is equal to 2. So, 2 comma 0 is 1 point. So, 2 comma 0 is somewhere here. 0 comma 2 is somewhere here. So, join these. Whenever you have a straight line, just join these two points. Okay, find out two points. So, this is the line. This is the point 0 comma 2. This is the point 2 comma 0. Okay. And what about this intersecting point? This is the curve y is equal to x squared. What about this point? Now you have to find out the point of intersection. Point of intersection will be you have to substitute x is equal, y is equal to 2 minus x in x squared, you will get one point, that is 1 comma 1 will be the intersecting point. Okay, 1 comma 1. You may get another one negative also. You need not consider that. We want this only. So, because x varies from 0 to x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1 is this line. This is the line x is equal to 1. Okay. Now, this is our in a region enclosed by all these four curves. So, this is the region. Okay. Now, what is the given order? Dy dx. Given order. Now, you have to check. Given order is dy dx. Dy dx means they have considered the vertical strip. right? In this vertical strip, y varies from both the ends, find the values of y. And what about this line? X plus y is equal to 2. So y varies from x squared, y is equal to x squared, given order. Please verify y varies from x squared to y is equal to 2 minus x. The both the ends, this end is moving along the curve, y is equal to x squared. This end is moving along the line, x plus y is equal to 2. Therefore, y is equal to x squared to y is equal to 2 minus x. And move the strip from left to right. Left, it can come up to the point x is equal to 0. And right hand side, it can move up to the point 1, 1. There at that point, x value is 1. Okay. Are they the limits? Yes. X squared to 2 minus x, x equal to 0 to 1. Okay. Yes. So, whatever we have drawn is correct. Please check whether it is correct or not. Okay. Whatever we have shaded, the region is correct or not. Yes. We have checked now. Now, you have to draw. Now, changed order is dx, dy. Changed order is dx, dy. Right? So, if you change the order now, dx, dy means what? Immediately horizontal strip. Now, there is a small problem here. See, I am drawing one horizontal strip from here. And you are drawing the horizontal strip here. You can draw in the region anywhere, you can draw the horizontal strip, right? So, I am drawing here and you are drawing in this line. So, according to me, I will tell that x varies from 0 to right hand side x is equal to root y, right? And you will tell that, no, no, ma'am, this is wrong. I have drawn here. Why don't you consider this? X is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2 minus y is correct, ma'am. Why are you taking x is equal to root y? If I draw the strip here, then it will be changed, right? So, I am telling that I have drawn the correct line. You are telling that you have drawn the correct horizontal. Because both are horizontal strips, right? Yes, both are correct in fact. Okay. But you have to consider both. Remember, this left hand side is moving throughout the region. If you draw the horizontal strip throughout the region, the left hand side is moving along the same line x is equal to 0. But the right hand side of the strip is not moving along the line y is equal to, I am telling it is moving along the line x square, x is equal to root y, right? It is not the, it is not correct throughout the region. Up to which point it is taking that curve? Up to the point 1, 1. At this point y is equal to 1. Okay. This straight line is y is equal to 1. This line is dividing the region into two equal parts, two regions. This is two region 1 and region 2. So, in region 1, you have to consider whatever I have considered. In region 2, you have to consider whatever you have considered. Understood? So, whatever I have drawn, this is my region and this is your region. So, both of us are correct. So, you have to find out my region also and you have to evaluate in your region also. You have to add both. Therefore, you have to divide the entire region into R1 plus R2. Okay. So, the given region is divided into R1 plus R2. Therefore, double integral over the given region R, what is the function? XY. Integrand is XY. XY into dx dy. Changed order is dx dy is equal to double integral over R1 xy dx dy plus double integral over R2 xy dx dy. Understood? So, in both the regions, you have to find out separately now. So, in R1, x varies from 0 to root y. X varies from 0 to root y. X equal to 0 to x is equal to root y. Right? Then move the strip from bottom to top. Bottom it can come up to the point 0, 0. And top it can go and coincide with the line y is equal to 1. Okay, so y varies from 0 to 1. Y varies from 0 to y is equal to 1. What about in R2? In the second region, x varies from 0 to 2 minus y. So x is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 2 minus y, right? And what about y value now? Now R1 is over. We are bothered about the region R2 only. So here it varies from y is equal to 1, 2. Maximum it can come up to the point here, 0, 2, right? Therefore, y varies from 1, 2. Y is equal to 2. At that point, y is equal to 2. Okay? Therefore, in R1 and R2, this will become integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to root y, xy, dx, dy. Okay, evaluate this. You will be getting 1 by 6. Okay, this answer will be 1 by 6. And the second integral here, R2, it will become 0 to 2 minus y, inner integral. And y varies from 1 to 2. Okay. Xy into dx dy. And this integral will be 5 by 24. Therefore, the required integral is double integral over Rxy dx dy will be equal to 1 by 6 plus 5 by 24, which is 9 by 24, or 3 by 8 is the answer. Okay. So, with this, change of order of integration is over. If you still have any doubts, you can post. If you don't understand anything, any step in this, please post it in the comment box. I will answer. And next is double integral in polar coordinates. We'll see in the next class. Thank you so much for listening.